how do you think they need to strengthen the team next year?
Obviously, I think we need a striker because obviously Sturridge is injured. Doesn't look like he's going to be back for a while, so we need a definite striker. We need to start playing with a striker, but the team who's sort of just has got a lot of number 10s, but no one with the focal point playing right up front. And I think that's his priority. I think that should be. And hopefully he buys just two or three other top players. Go for quality rather than quantity, if they're available, of course. And that's always the difficult part.
And last week there was the banner before the game of Rodgers out, Rafa in. What do you make of that? Do you think that's something that the fans are after? Would it be good for the club?
Well, as a manager of Liverpool Football Club or any big club these days, the pressure is always on if you're not successful. And to be fair, like Brendan, obviously last year we were second, this year it's been poorer. But that sort of pressure comes in, you have to take that. I hope personally that Liverpool are big enough to stick with him, give him a chance to get it right somewhere down the line. But in football, there's no tomorrow, everybody wants you to do it today and you have to be successful. And I think next year is probably a big chance for him to do that.
And do you think Benitez could ever come back to Liverpool, with how much the fans love him?
Actually, all the younger fans like Rafa because obviously with the Istanbul game, they all love that part of it, and that gave them sort of an identity, if you like. You never know in football. I think he always likes Liverpool. He likes where he lived over the water, and again, I'd be surprised if he come back. I don't think it's always the greatest thing you can do.
And you've got a lot of good English rising stars coming through at Liverpool. Who are their favourites at the moment? Jordan Ibe, likes of Sterling, Henderson. Which ones are you backing to go on to big things?
Well, I think all three of them that you've mentioned, they've all got a great future ahead of them. Obviously, there's some distress about whether Sterling stays or not. Hopefully, he will, because I think that's the best for his football ability to stay with Liverpool at least for another couple of years. And Jordan Ibe, I think, has got a great talent and needs maybe to have an end product, needs to score more goals, if you like, but he's certainly got the quality to do that. And Henderson, I think, has proved himself now, year in, year out, and he's got better with every season. Obviously, there was some criticism when he first come about the amount of money, but I think he's proved himself to be a worthy player, and he's a top Liverpool player now.
Do you think he could be as good as Gerrard, Henderson?
Well, he'll never be the same as Steven Gerrard. I mean, you can't replace a player with that sort of quality. Henderson is a completely different type of player. But what you get off him is honesty every week. He works really hard for the team. Plays in all sorts of different positions. But I think you've got to start playing right in the centre of the midfield. He's got to play from there, and he's got to become a bigger player in terms of now Steven's gone.
With the Sterling contract row, you had a similar situation with McManaman when he was younger. How do you handle it as a manager, and what's the best approach for you?
Well, it's slightly different because obviously McManaman was there for 12 years. He gave the club 12 years of great football, and I think he was entitled to go. Obviously, the club weren't happy, I suppose, that it was on a Bosman contract and that they got nothing, and some of the fans didn't like that. But you have to remember that he gave us, say 12 great years, and he was a brilliant player. And Sterling's just about got into the first team this year. He's become the new boy in the block. And I think sometimes you have to pay a little bit back. I mean, the fans would be very disappointed if he walked away to a Man City or a Chelsea or whatever. And he might not even get in them teams if he's not careful. So I think he's got to think about it sensibly. Okay, maybe the agent's stirring things up. That's always not a good sign at the end of the day. But if he's got good common sense, I think he'll do as he said he will do. Discuss at the end of the season and sign a new contract.
Do you think they're similar players in any way, McManaman and Sterling?
No, I don't think that's... I mean, the difference in McManaman was probably as very intelligent as a footballer and liked to come in off the wide areas. They're different, but they both create opportunities, obviously, with the pace. Sterling is electric over small distance of it. McManaman could run for long distance pass players. But the only thing that's good about them, they're both the two great players, and hopefully that say we can manage to keep Sterling.
With McManaman being so successful when he did leave, do you think this is probably something that Sterling looks at and uses as an influence if he is going to go?
Well, I hope he doesn't look at that way, because Steve McManaman went to Real Madrid at the end of the day, because obviously he went there and towards the end of his career, but he had 4 or 5 good years there as well. And he was quite entitled to do that. I mean, in the modern day game, unfortunately, there's not a lot of players stick around and stay at the club. We're just about to lose one along with Steven Gerrard, obviously. Most players come and go, but it'd be nice to see a little bit of loyalty, certainly from a young lad who's come through the system.
And you've been a coach for so many years. Who was the most impressive you've ever seen training, and the one that you thought was going to be the greatest?
Well, I'll always have to say that after my team, Fowler and McManaman were two. To be fair, when they worked together, obviously they could create magic. They could score goals. So they've always been sort of my favourite two, if you like, in a sense, because they came through the system and became very successful at the top level. And I was always mentioned them. Over my 35 years, of course, there's been some fantastic players year in, year out. Goalkeepers, centre forwards, centre halves. But they're the two that I enjoyed watching in my time.